good. I was singing Michael Bublé. Perfect for Christmas songs. Okay, well, this video has nothing to do with Christmas. Sorry. Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. So, I asked you guys like 3 weeks ago to ask me some skincare related questions, and today is the video where I answer them. So I'm gonna go through and answer most of your questions that you guys have for me, at least to the best of my ability. If I've ever experienced something that you guys have asked about, or if I have some tips and tricks that I use, then I'll tell you guys all about that today. So I'm super excited about it. I love skincare, I love talking about skincare, oh my gosh. So before we get straight into the video, I wanna say a big ol' thank you to Sephora Collection for sponsoring this video. And for those of you that don't know, I am a Sephora Collection ambassador. I love working for them. I love, love, love their products. They're so, so good. So today we're gonna be chatalating about their new face masks and also the Holy Sheet Mask Challenge. So how to enter the challenge is you literally just take a selfie or like a picture of yourself face masking in public. So whatever you're doing, maybe you're going to school, maybe you're going to coffee or shopping or with friends or whatever it is, you take a picture of that. So all you do is tag Sephora Collection and the hashtag Holy Sheet Mask Challenge, and that'll enter you guys into being possibly featured on their Instagram stories or their Instagram feed. It's really not meant to be a super serious challenge, I mean, obviously. So be sure you guys have a lot of fun with it and don't take it too seriously, because that's what makes it fun. So I wish you the best of luck and have so much fun with it. My tasks that I need to do today are cleaning and doing some assignments. I was already assigned like all of my assignments for the semester, so I want to get a little bit of a roll on them, just sit organized on top of it. So that's basically just what I need to do today. So while I do that, I'm gonna face mask up and do my own version of the Holy Sheet Mask Challenge. But basically, like, the whole theme around it is that like your skincare doesn't stop when you become busy. Like, your skincare can be 24/7 basically. So girl, we prepared. I love face masks. Okay, so okay, I want to show you at least the supercharged ones. There's a bubble mask, there's a primer mask, and I literally just use the charcoal and the mud mask. But they're super great. I really liked how they worked. So I think I'm gonna use maybe one of the regular ones today. I don't know which one yet. I'll have to figure that out. Oh, this is trouble. Also, these start from $3 to $8, and Sephora Collection is having a promotion right now. If you buy three, you get one free, which is super great. And obviously, it's super, super easy to get that hydration on. You literally put on a mask and you're like instantly hydrated. So once I finish my Holy Sheet Challenge, then we're gonna roll into the questions that you guys had for me that you asked me on Instagram like 3 weeks ago, and I'll do the best of my ability to answer them all for you. Okay, so it was a really hard decision, but I think I'm gonna use the Perfecting and Brightening face mask, the pearl one. It's my favorite. It smells so, so good. So we're gonna pop this bad boy on. I could use a bit of some brightening action going on, maybe. It's pink too. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. I should have put my hair up before I did this. Oops. Oh well. Oh, I totally sniffed that up my nose. Woo! It's cold. Okay, I popped my hair up. We're good to go. But for real, I need to go do some cleaning, and I'm gonna work on some assignments, get organized, all that shaboodle. Is, which is your favorite mask? By the way, I love you so much. Thanks, I love you too. I would say pearl eye mask. It smells so good, and I think it brightens up my face. That's the one I just used in this video. I smell amazing, and my face is a lot brighter. I would say it helps really nicely with the complexion. I never really noticed that I need to like brighten my face, but I can always tell the difference when I use the mask versus when I don't. How do I know if a product is suitable for me? So the best advice I can give you on this is, I think if you start a new skincare routine, it takes like 6 to 8 weeks before you actually start seeing results. So if you don't like your routine, you feel like you're just struggling with acne or dryness or whatever your problem may be, try switching up your routine and finding other products, but give it like 6 to 8 weeks to see if you can tell a difference in your skin quality or not. It takes a minimum of that much time in order to see if your skin is responding well or not to the products. Stay really, really consistent on your routine, because then you'll be able to tell and see what works and what doesn't work. Okay, next one. What is your skin type? My skin type, I would say it's probably normal to dry. I don't really struggle with oiliness so much. Sometimes I have buildup of oil like right over here, but it's nothing crazy. If anything, I struggle with a lot of dryness, especially in the winter. My skin literally feels like scales. Otherwise, I would say it's pretty normal in like spring to summer, but fall to winter is when I really get dry and I really, really need hydration. Next question, how do you get rid of the little bumps around your hairline? Okay, I struggle with this more than anything, I think, besides the breakouts or dryness. The little bumps, like it comes like literally on my forehead or by my eyebrows. It's just so, it drives me crazy. But what I find is I just have to wait it out. It's so annoying, but I don't really know how to make them go away. It's super frustrating. What face wash do you use? I know with me personally, if I have any extra scents in my cleansers or like perfumes or whatever, that irritates my skin. So that's an extra irritant that I don't need. I find using a very plain sudsy soap works great. Again, back to the basics. I just want a cleanser to clean my face. That is it. I don't need anything extra on top of that. Very neutral, no scents, no extra irritants. It's literally just basic face soap. Somebody asks, what's your skin problems? I have bad breakouts. When I break out bad. And actually the older I've gotten, the worse the breakouts at least have gotten. Like I have one over here, it's finally going down, but I had a big old zit just right in the middle of my face for like 4 or 5 days. I usually break out on my forehead too. It's just the breakouts that are really, really a problem for me. And they tend to just stay there for a while. Homemade remedy for acne, which worked for you. Honestly, I've never done homemade skincare. I hear there's really great things and there's some great foods that work super great for your skin and your hair. I just haven't been one to dive deep into it. So I'm not exactly sure how they work. I just use a lot of face masks, or I just wash my face, put lotion on, make sure my skin is hydrated, and that's honestly about it. Next up, what do you use for blackheads, whiteheads, and acne? Oh my gosh. So I have these like little pore strips I usually use on my nose. I have not used one since like 2 months ago, ever since I had a really bad experience with it. And I put one of my little blackhead remover strips on my nose. And it was like one of the ultra ones, so it was really strong. And I had never had a problem with it before. For some reason I did now. And I left it on for like 15 minutes, whatever. And when I pulled it off, first of all, it was really, really painful. But besides the point, I was like expecting that. When I pulled it off, my skin right on the top of my nose must be so thin or fragile or whatever, it actually left a big old burn mark on my nose. When I took it off, I was like, oh my gosh, what is this on my face? There was like a red mark, I'm not kidding you, like this big. It's so hard to like compare. It was huge. It wasn't a scratch. It was so bizarre. So it took like 3 or 4 days to go away. I don't know, it was so weird. So I used to use that for my nose, but I haven't used it since because I'm paranoid it's gonna happen again. What products do you use for dark spots, oily skin, and pores? Oily skin and pores, that's not one of my skin problems, so I don't really know. Again, so I just wash my face. But as far as dark spots, I would say my dark under eye circles, I have that. I just use concealer. I'm not really one about the brightening and the color correcting. I feel like all of that product looks so cakey and it just does not look like a very smooth finish, so I just forego it. I like to just pop on a little bit of concealer. I do just a little bit and then I bring it all the way out under my eyes because that little bit of product will make it all the way under your eye, I promise. You don't need a whole line. Another question, I break out a lot on my nose all the time. How do I help clear up and prevent breakouts? In general, honestly, I would say just wash your face day and night. When you dry off your face, make sure you're using a clean face towel. Only that towel for your face. If you're using one that you dry your hands on and it's a little bit dirty, remember, you're putting that on your face. So all of those germs and dirt and bacteria is gonna be on your face. We can't have that. So that could be another issue why you're breaking out. Maybe you think you're doing well and you're washing your face. Ah, perfect, time to go to bed, you dry it off, and you don't realize you're shoving all of that dirt into your face that you just cleaned off. So have a very clean towel that you use only for your face. Okay, next one, how to look fresh all the time. Ooh, I like this one. I would say you always wanna have a nice bright face, right? So when you wake up in the morning, make sure you have a nice clean face. Wash off your face. Because remember, your face is your canvas for your makeup. So you have kind of dirty, maybe not clean face, you're gonna put makeup on top of that, and your makeup can't look super good if you don't have a nice clean canvas. One more tip I can give you is to use a toner. Sometimes a toner helps brighten up your face. So if you're struggling with dullness or you feel like you just want a little pop of something, find a good toner. Also a natural one I hear that works really well is lemon juice. I haven't really tried it for myself, but I hear it works wonders. So try doing that. That'll just be really easy to freshen up your face a little bit without doing like anything. Ooh, I like this one too. Is diet important for skin? It absolutely is important for skin. If you eat a high content of salt and sugar and you don't drink a whole lot of water, that is a perfect mixture for a lot of acne. I'm not perfect either. I eat lots of snacks, I eat lots of sugar, and I notice a difference when I eat really healthy versus when I don't eat very healthy. Like, if I drink a whole lot of water, I eat very lean, I don't have hardly any sugars, compared to when I eat fun snacks and I eat salty chips and I eat fun gummy worms and all those fun stuff, and I don't drink so much water, that is when I break out more. So diet is a huge thing. If you clean up your diet, you're gonna see a difference in your face. And also be sure you're drinking lots and lots and lots of water. That will help you immensely. So I hope this was helpful for you, and if you're trying a new skincare routine, I wish you the best of luck, and don't give up. Just keep on pressing forward, and be sure you wait 6 to 8 weeks until you can actually see those changes. Okay, you guys, that's all I have for you guys today, but I hope you found this video helpful. I will have all the links to these bad boys down below in the description box, so you won't miss them. And there are literally so many, you gotta try them. I've been using the aloe vera one and the pearl eye mask lately, and I absolutely love them. So be sure you guys check those all down below in the description box. And also, before I forget, don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you have not already. And I will see you guys next week. Bye-bye.